In this video, I'll demonstrate the Machine Language Analytics page of the Ruckus Analytics tool. The Analytics page provides a breakdown of incidents by severity and category, allowing you to focus on the incidents of interest for which you can view details. For any given incident, you can view the severity, the client impact, the root cause, and recommendations, as well as the events, anomalies, data, or problems that were used to identify the incident. The Analytics page contains a number of components, which include some of the following that are on this slide, such as the Network Filtering menu, the Severity Filtering tab, Network Impact tile, and so forth. So from the dashboard, to get to the Analytics tab, I would just select the Analytics tab on the left. So let's go around and kind of show you what we have here. In the upper right is our date. So this is our what we're going to slice and dice our data into. We can have today or last 24 hours, 7 days, last month, or custom. And if I selected custom, for example, I would select like particular day or week or whatever. So we'll go back and just pick the last 24 hours here. Next is our network function. So we'll click on the network menu to select a network node within the circle packing representation. By default, the network is selected, which displays a circle packing view of the system in the entire network. A network node can be a cluster, a domain, a zone, an AP, a group, or an access point in the network. So for example, if I roll over these, you can see that Bug Bash, and this is my virtual smart zone 34. Here we have our density virtual smart zone cluster. So I could select that. Let me just click on that. And you'll notice that that brings up my network and my density VSC cluster. And then I could click on the arrow to close this down. What that shows over on the left is my network node details tile. So it shows where I'm at. In this case, I'm the smart zone cluster. Gives me the name of the cluster, the type, the firmware, the number of APs, and the clients that are in that particular node. And if I wanted to go back and change that back, I could go ahead and click on network. And I'll go ahead and click that, and we'll take it back up to the network level. And then we'll click out of that. Next to the network, we have our categories of incidences. So we have connections, performance, and infrastructure. By default, they're all selected. But let's say, for example, I just wanted to look at my performance, and I could untick those, and then I could click apply, and it'll go ahead and apply those settings. And now we're looking at just the one category, and you'll notice that the number of incidences and so forth has gone down. And a lot of these, you'll notice that in performance, these are going to be P3 or P4 incidences down here. So let's go ahead and reselect those, and I'll tick those back, and we'll hit apply, and that'll refresh it. And now it shows that we have all of our incidences. Under the network node details, we have our severity filter. And this severity filter tallies the total number of incidences on the network node that's been selected and lists the number of incidents by severity. So for example, you can see that we have 37 P1, 1 P2, 7 P3s, and 254 P4s. If I select P1, it'll turn that off. And I could turn it back on just by clicking on it again. To the right of the severity filter, I have my incident timberline, and I can roll my mouse button and I can scroll and zoom in and out on this. But this essentially lists my new clients, my impacted clients, and the connected clients. So the total connected clients is the heavy line, the new clients is the light gray line, and then the impacted clients, as you go along here, it just shows you how many clients have been impacted. So for example, at this particular case, the impacted clients are 62. And underneath this is my incident list of tables. So these are sorted by severity, starting with P1, which is the most severe. I could slice and dice this. I could look at only P1, P2, P3, or P4. So let's say, for example, I wanted to look at P4. And you'll notice that each incident is made up of a number of attributes. You could have date and time. You could have description. And under description here, you have a short description. But if I roll over that, it'll actually give me a readout of what the suspected root cause is. The category, so in this case, it would be connection. The subcategory, and we got DHCP, we got EAP, and so forth across the scope and the type. And under type, you could have smart zone cluster, domain zone, AP group, and so forth. And then we have details over here. Let's say, for example, I want to take this DHCP error here, and I want to get some detailed information on that. So I could click on details, and this will bring up my incident details page. So for example, here it says Incident details, DHCP failures are unusually high in this particular access point. Underneath that, it shows the network impact. So it lists the WLAN. In this case, we only have one. The reason, it says 100% of the failures are caused by a timeout, which is expired. If I right arrow, it shows the client manufacturers that are affected. In this case, it's all Intel clients. And it shows which radios were being used. So in this particular case, we're only using the 5 gigahertz radio. And then if I hit the right arrow again, it just cycles around and it kind of repeats itself here. So on the right, we have the root cause analysis, and then we have a recommended action. So for example, DHCP exchange is failing because of a timeout waiting for a response from the DHCP server. This is typically caused by the following reasons. So this is the information that's been put together by the machine learning analysis. So it could say the DHCP server is offline, the server is unreachable, the VLAN or DVLAN infrastructure is not properly configured, and it gives you a few other things, and then it gives you some recommendations. Is the DHCP server online with scopes configured and available addressing? Is the DHCP server available, and so forth? Underneath that is my incident information. It gives me the client impact count. In this case, it's only one of one client. And I can then view details, and it'll bring up the impacted client's information. So under that, it's got the MAC address, the SSID, the username, the host name, and so forth. And then I have two links over here. I have client detailed report, and I have a troubleshooting report. So let's click on the troubleshooting report. And that'll bring up a health summary here. There's not a whole lot of data here because it was a connection problem. So as there was a DHCP failure, timeout expired. You notice this little red dot here. So if I click on this red dot on my graph here, it actually brings up a troubleshooting diagram. This is my connection events details. So this will actually pinpoint down what's going on. So the client is sending out a DHCP discover, the offer's coming back, then the DHCP discover is going out and back and forth, and then we have a DHCP request comes out, which is not acknowledged. So this actually gives a very detailed blow-by-blow account of what's going on. Now let's go back to the previous page. And if we click on View Details, and we do a Client Detailed Report, this puts us then into the reporting engine of our analytics tool. Now, in this case, there's not much information because there was no data to display. So let's go back and pick one more incident. So back under my incident level, I'm going to select one that's EAP failures are unusually high on a particular access point that has three clients over here. So we'll go ahead and select that one. So in this case, we see our report, the WLANs that are affected. We have several WLANs here. We have a couple reasons. One is unspecified, station, disassociation, and a timeout. And then we go over to the client manufacturers. In this case, we have several client manufacturers. We can right-click on that. Once again, it's only affecting the 5 gigahertz band. And then we cycle back to the beginning. So once again, we have recommendations over here, but if I go to the view details, and it'll bring up the impacted clients. So here we have an Apple client, so let's go ahead and click on the troubleshooting aspect of that. And here we see a little bit more information. So we have some connection events, and we do have some red dots up here. So if I click on one of those, here once again, we have the connection event details. And I can scroll down through here, and you can see here that on the four-way handshake on the third frame is where our error showed up. So this just kind of shows you how you can drill down into the troubleshooting phase of this. And let's go back one screen. And under View Details again, if I go into my Client Detailed Report, once again, this will take me over to my reporting function of the analytics tool. And now we do have some data on this. So it gives me my top applications by traffic, gives me my traffic trends, traffic by radio, RSS trends, a whole lot of information as we drill down through the reports. And we'll have a separate video on the report section on how to analyze this type of data. So this is just a quick overview of the Ruckus Analytics tab. And as you can see, this is a very powerful tool to aid in troubleshooting your network.